Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're going to be solving equations using straight lines. Now this video is going to be really important because it's a connection between our work we've done on algebra for solving equations and the work we've done on drawing straight lines and linking the two. So it's really quite a useful video, both in terms of making your understanding better and in terms of revising old concepts. Now, just previously on Hegarty Maths, you've solved equations like this. Pause the video and double check you can do that. Okay, hopefully fairly easily you would have got the following. X is 2. And don't forget to check your answer. 3 times 2, 6. 6 add 2, 8. Yeah, absolutely. And it's very easy for us to have solved linear equations like that. Now, I just want to show you that those can also be solved using graphs. The way these may come up in textbooks and homeworks and exams, etc., is that they'll show you some graphs and they'll say to you, using the graph shown, find the solutions to the following. So let me just lead you into that with another little bit of warm-up work. Draw the lines with equations y equals 3x add 2 and y equals 8. Pause the video and double-check you can do that. Well, this one's the easiest. That's the line when y is 8. All the coordinates where y is always 8. So you could just do a few for yourself, and it's easy. You can spot it's where y is 8, it's going to be this one here, this line here. Okay, and that's the line y equals 8. Now what about this one? Well, this has a gradient of 3 and a y-intercept the y-intercept is going to be 0, 2 because its c is there. So we go up to here, we start at the y-intercept. Gradient of 3 means as you go across one unit, you go up 3 units. As you go across one unit, you go up 3 units there. And we're getting our straight line, which we can draw without much difficulty, almost perfectly like that. Now let's just point out where these two lines intersect or cross. Well, they intersect or cross here, and that's at the coordinates x is 2 and y is equal to 8. Now, if you remember back to the first question I asked you to solve 3x add 2 is 8. Remember I asked you to solve this equation here, 3x add 2 is equal to 8, and you got the answer x is equal to 2. And when we drew the graph y equal to 3x add 2 and y equal to 8, they also crossed where x is equal to 2. And it so happens that if we want to solve equations, we could draw this side as a straight line, this side as a straight line, and where they intersect, the x number where they intersect is also going to be the solution to that equation, right? And you will often be given the lines drawn for you, and it will just say, using the lines drawn, solve the equation. And you won't necessarily be allowed to use algebraic methods. You'll have to use the lines given to you. So let's do some examples. Now, I'm making it a tiny bit harder for the purpose of the video here. You will usually be given the lines drawn for you. I'm going to make us draw the lines as well, just to like get us a bit of practice again at drawing lines. Although, obviously, to draw the lines and solve it is longer than just solving the blooming thing, and it would be easier to solve. But I don't want you to do that. I want you to practice with me drawing the line and also using those lines to solve. So, what two lines would you draw to solve this equation? Well, if you drew the line y is equal to 2x subtract 5, okay, that side, and you drew the line y is equal to 7, that side, where they would intersect would be the solution to those. So let's draw those lines. Let's draw y is 7. It's dead easy, that one. Y is 7 is that one there, which we just need to move down a little bit like that. And 2x subtract 5, well, that has gradient of 2, and it has a y-intercept of 0, negative 5. So let's go to 0, negative 5, and gradient of 2. Across 1, up 2. Across 1, up 2. Across 1, up 2. Across 1, up 2, across 1, up 2, and across 1, up 2. Oh look, there's the point of intersection. So if we were to draw these lines here, like that, and we're going to have our solution. So this line, remember to label them, that is y is equal to 7, and this line here is going to be equal to y equals 2x subtract 5. And where do they intersect? Well, they intersect here at the coordinates 6, 7. So the solution to this equation is x is equal to 6, and that's our answer. Okay, and if you substitute in, 2 times 6 is 12, 12 take away 5 is 7, absolutely. And there you go, using straight lines to solve equations. Remember I told you these will normally be given to you and you will use them, so you won't have to draw them. I'm only drawing them with you so that you get a bit of extra practice drawing straight lines, because you can't practice this stuff enough. Right, let's do another one. Pause the video. State the two lines you draw. If you want to draw them, you can draw them on graph paper and then solve the equations using that method. Okay, I would draw the equations, the straight lines, y equals 3x subtract 6 and y is equal to negative 3. Let's draw the y is negative 3 first, should be easy. That's that one. This one here has a gradient of 3 and a y-intercept of 0, negative 6. So let's start at 0 as negative 6, go across 1, go up 3. Across 1, up 3. And that should be enough to draw our straight line. We've got 3 points there. And there you go. That's pretty good. And this is the equation y equals 3x subtract 6. This one is y equals negative 3. You can see where they intersect. They're intersecting here at the coordinates x is 1 and y is negative 3. So the solution, if we're looking to find x here, the solution is x is equal to 1. And let's check it. 3 times 1 is 3. 3 take away 6, negative 3, absolutely. Remember, you won't necessarily have to draw the lines. You would just use lines pre-drawn, but we're just practicing that. Right, let's try another one. Same old stuff. What two lines would you draw here? Well, here, I'm going to draw the line y is equal to 3x subtract 6. And here, I'm going to draw the line y is equal to x subtract 2. So this one here has a gradient of 3 and a y-intercept of 0, negative 6. This one here has a gradient of 1 and a y-intercept of 0, negative 2. So let's try and draw those lines. Let's start with the blue one. Start at 0, negative 6. Gradient of 3 means across 1, up 3, across 1, up 3, across 1, up 3, like that. This is looking good like that, something like that. Label that up, y equals 3x subtract 6. Let's do the other one now. Let's start at 0, negative 2. Gradient of 1, so across 1, up 1, across 1, up 1, across 1, up 1, across 1, up 1. We seem to have enough points there. Let's draw that straight line in. Just need to sort that out. Something like that. That's about right there. And that's the line y equals x subtract 2, and we can see where they intersect. They are intersecting here at the coordinates 2 and 0. So the solution, the x value solution, must be x is equal to 2. Let's check it. 3 times 2 is 6. 6 take away 6 is 0. 2 take away 2 is 0. Yep, absolutely, we got the answer. Let's have a go at another one. Pause the video. State the equation, state the straight lines you draw. Draw the straight lines if you've got graph paper and work out the solutions by using graphical methods. Okay, I draw y is equal to 5x subtract 2. I would also draw the line y is equal to 2x add 4 and see where they intersect. This one has a gradient of 5 and a y-intercept of 0, negative 2. This one here has a gradient of 2 and a y-intercept of 0, 4. So let's draw these out. Start here with the blue one. Gradient of 5 means across 1, up 5, across 1, up 5, and let's go back 1 and down 5 like that. So that should be enough for that one there. Looks something like that. Okay, and there we go, that's the equation y is equal to 5x subtract 2. Let's try and draw the other one now, 2x add 4. So we're going to start at 0, 4. Got a gradient of 2, go across 1, go up 2, go across 1, go up 2. Why don't we go back 1 and go down 2? We've got enough points there. That should be pretty good for us. And there is the equation, y equals 2x add 4. Now, where do they intersect? They seem to be intersecting here at 2, 8. So the x solution for these is x is going to be equal to 2. Let's check it's true. 5 times 2 is 10, 10 take away 2 is 8, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 add 4 is 8. Absolutely, we've got the right answer and we're done. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks for watching.